Good afternoon to everybody who has joined in to today's masterclass. It's a continuation of yesterday's class. So people who have been into yesterday's session would be aware of where we've reached. For people who have joined in today, a quick introduction about our expert, Mr. Sandeep Rai. He's a senior network engineer. He's also worked in different domains and technologies as a technological analyst and also works for CPG and ISIS technology as a network administrator. He's a very familiar face amongst us as he kind of does a lot of masterclass, especially in the network security arena. For familiar faces, you guys are aware of how his classes are. So just a brief about him. He is quite often the person who kind of helps us share the network arena of routers, bridges, and switches, and other fundamentals about it. So without any further delay, I'd request Sandeep sir to get the class started. Whatever questions you guys have, please start posting them in the chat. We'll definitely pick those questions up towards the end of it. Right, Sandeep sir, up to you. Thank you so much for being here today.
Yeah, thanks Kaushik. Thanks everyone for joining here. Let me quickly share my screen. All right, let me know if you guys can see that.
Yep, it's visible.
Okay, so about today's agenda, as Kaushik mentioned, it's all the fundamental of networking. I think the previous two classes, we discussed more in detail about OSI reference model, switching to the network, and the flow of your local area connection. Today's class is mainly focused on routing, which is exactly the core of your networking. When you deal with WAN technology, when you deal with communication between two different networks, and today we are going to discuss this in details. So agenda, just a glance for you guys. It's like we are going to discuss what exactly the role of router into the network infrastructure, and then just a quick pickup of the router sample. I'll show you like how the connection happens. When you get a new model of router, how do you prepare that to connect to your network? What exactly you do, how you access at the beginning, and then you start configuring this. So those things we will see, and then how routing works, what type of routing we have. So how routing work is one of the what is called core heart of your networking. If you understand this concept, you are a network engineer in real, because in actual, many of the guys who works daily basis, but not sure how exactly the routing flow happens. So configuration is different, but understanding the flow, and that helps you to troubleshoot many occasions. Then we go with types of routing, static routes, dynamic routes. If time permits, I'll touch EIGRP, which is itself a vast topic, but yeah, we will see. All right, so let's begin. So very first question, why do we use router in our environment? Why cannot we use a switch and finish our networking? So let me tell you very interesting things. When you go and let's say that in other countries where you are not aware of their language, they are not aware of your language, you need someone in middle who can translate your language to them and their language to you, okay? And which tell you the path how to reach to let's say that them, or how they can reach out to you. Your router exactly does the same thing. Your network, you are having a separate IP address network. And when you want to talk to other network, let's say other company's network, okay, they will not understand your IP addressing, and you will not understand their IP addressing. And the question is like, how can I communicate with them? And that's where I need router. A router is the guy who will help us to communicate to the other network. Okay, in the layman language, it's like, It's the forwarding your request to the other guy and his request back to you. It's a man in middle. Okay. So generally, as I referred the word or term forwarding. This is what router known for. It's forward your packet to the internet, internet packet back to you. And that's how you access Google or Microsoft or many other such sites. So let's say that I'm chatting with you, I'm talking to you, and I am connected to the internet. Even you guys are connected to your internet. And because of this router, because of this forwarding mechanism, we all are able to communicate to each other. Irrespective, we are sitting on two different networks, okay? Example, quickly, you all can go to the command prompt of your system. It's very simple, just go to Windows R, you press, you'll get this run dialog box, type there CMD, and this will tell you what is the IP address of your laptop. So just you need to type ipconfig. When you type ipconfig, you can see your laptop IP address. And in my case, I have 192.168.2.10. Many of you will be having 192.168.1. or such like that. Okay. So this is called IP address of your PC. This is called the subnet mask. And the third one is a very important. This is called your default gateway. So your default, in my case, I have my default gateway 192.168.56.1. Okay. So like that, you will be seeing, if you see this one, this is what my internet IP 192.168.1.8, 192.168.1.1 is my router IP. And whenever I want to connect to internet, my all traffics blindly go to this default gateway. And this is nothing but my router. Okay. So by saying this, it's very clear that if I want to communicate to google.com, which is having different IP, example, what is the IP of google.com? Let's see here. I will simply ping that. Do you see? Its IP is 172.217.174.164. This is not the IP, this range IP is not belong to my laptop. My laptop is having simple IP, something like that 192.168.1.1. So how I'm communicating to this? This is the different subnet. And that's where router play the role. Okay. Now, how the flow happens, how it goes from my laptop to router, router to internet, and return traffic comes, that we will see in the next slides. But at the moment, why do we need router? To communicate to two different subnets. All right. Guys, just quick interaction. Just let me know if I am audible very quiet or it's there is any low.
Sandeep, you're audible, Sandeep. Probably a bit louder, but then I think you're clear. Yes.
Okay. Last time I was.
If anyone has any experience, please drop a message in the chat. Anybody else? Because you're audible, loud and clear.
Thank you. Thanks, Kosit. All right. So that's all about router role into our network infrastructure. It's generally help us to communicate to two different subnets. In my case, it's internet. When I go back to next, which is the components of router, how router exactly looks like. So if you see here, let me pick up my pen. Yeah. So if you see here, it is a device. I mean, it's a 2600 Cisco router. There are many routers in the real world. You can have like Cisco, you can have D-Link, you can have many such, Juniper. But what exactly or widely what we use is the Cisco router. I'm not promoting Cisco for you for information, but that's what is the real stick. So we have in widely ranged Cisco routers and how it exactly looks like. So if you see like it's have power cable, obviously all devices will be having one power port where you'll connect to your power cable, then only it will switch on, then a power switch. Auxiliary port, we will talk about this later on, not important. The important at the moment for us is the console port. You can see this, it's written console. I'll just make it a little larger. And if you see this console port, this is where you need to deal with in your network devices. Whenever you want to configure any network devices, you need to search this console port. Okay. And if you find this console port, then it's very easy for you to access the device. So this console port will be there in the router, in the firewall, in the switches, and just you need to connect this console cable, this console port with the console cable to your laptop, desktop, and then you can access this device. Okay. All right. So what exactly, how the connection happens? If you see here, that the console port I was showing you some time back, and then this is the console cable. So this console cable, on one side it looks like your RJ45, other side it's called serial interface, we call this as a COM port. Okay, so it's DB9. Why do we call DB9? Because it's having 9 pin here in your system and the 9 holes in this side, so that it can easily connect to your system. And if you see in your desktop, your route servers, you will find this port. It's a 9-pin port where you will connect other side of the console cable, which is called DB9, and other side of the console cable, which is looks like RJ45, you connect to your router. And that's how you will finish your connectivity. So you can see it's depicted here. You can connect this PC with console cable to your router, and then you can access your device. Okay, and this is the very first step when you buy any router, firewall, switches, and you start configuring it. So you need to connect this to console cable. Nowadays, there is no serial port or DB9 COM port is available in the laptops or desktops. So now it is removed, this kind of interface, and now it is it's a USB port. So if you see, instead of this COM port, now you are getting the USB port, and other side would be the RJ45. All right, so that's how you will connect. Okay, so how routing works, let me first show you a small scenario, and then we will proceed on that. So if you see in my case, it's a lab which we will be doing together. In my case, you can see I have a router. I have a laptop. Let's say it's connected to my LAN switch, and the switch is connected to router. Router here, you can refer here as a R1 for router and switch for switch one. And then with the same router, I'm connecting another PC, and I want to communicate to each other. Okay. So let's go through the theory, and then I will start practical. When I connect a switch, as we all know, switch works on OSI reference layer. Anybody can tell me which layer? It's layer 2. And we call this layer 2 as a data link layer. What it does, okay? This generally, if you connect any PC with this, they will belong to same IP subnet. Example, 192.168.1. Let's say that 0/24. So in this case, I will give one IP to this PC called 192.168.1.1. And this PC, I'll give 192.168.1.2. And they will be start communicating to each other without any problem. As soon as you assign the IP, they will start communicating to each other. When you are connecting these two laptop to a switch. All right. Yeah. When you get a router, okay? When you get a router, the first rule of the router connection is, first rule, whatever you connect to the router, this interface and the connected device, whether it's a switch or whether it's a laptop, they should belong to same subnet. What do you mean by that? It means that if I'm connecting, let's say that this router is having interface FA0/0. I must give 192.168.1.1 if my PC is having this range of IP. If I will give here 2.2, this will not communicate. So any router directly connected interface should belong to same subnet. If I'm having 192.168.1.2, it must be 192.168.1.series IP here to accept your packet when you're sending. All right. Rule number two. So what was the rule number first? Directly connected device should have same subnet IP. Okay. Rule number two says, when you connect another device, let's say I connect another PC here on FA0/1. What is mean by FA? First Ethernet. And this interface of the router comes in fast Ethernet, which supports 100 Mbps. Gig Ethernet, which support 1 Gbps. So different router comes with a different speed of the interface. So FA0/1, I connected another PC. Let's say that PC number 2. And this is PC number 1. If I give 192.168.1.2 to my PC, your FA0/0, which is directly connected to this PC, should have 192.168.1.1 or this range of IP, anything you can give. But when you connect another PC to another interface of the router, they must have separate or different subnet. Different subnet than other interface what it is active. So if I am using FA0/0, 192.168.1.0 subnet, I must not use this subnet to here FA0/1, or else it will throw an error. So what should be here? Let's pick up anyone. I'll pick it up 192.168.3.0/24. So 3.0 and 1.0, is that same subnet or different subnet? It's a different subnet. We did this in the last class. How is it different? Because this belongs to class C. Class C means 3-octet network. And this 3-octet should be, if matching, they belong to same network, same subnet. If they are not matching, they belong to different subnet. So this is not matching here in my case. It means that it's different subnet. All right. Okay. So 192.168.3.series, I will give here 3.1 and this, sorry, 3.2, and this one I will give 3.1. What do you mean by that? 3.1? 192.168.3.2 to my PC and 192.168.3.1 to my router interface, FA0/1. Now your router rule number two is two different subnet of two different interface of router should have two different subnets. This is rule number two. And that's all. There is nothing complication. It's very simple stuff. The router will, each interface will have different subnet, rule number first. And whatever device you are connecting to that interface should belong to same subnet as that interface is. Hope I'm clear to you guys. Okay. So now let's move to the next level, the flow, how exactly flow happens. Okay. Kaushik, do we have any questions here so far?
I think there was one question. IP address is level 3 network layer. Why switch will care for IP as it is level 2?
Sorry, I did not understand.
I'm not able to clearly understand the question. It says IP address is level 3 network layer.
Exactly.
Why switch will care for IP as it is level 2?
He's absolutely right. And that's the reason I mentioned that it's working in data link layer. So what is mean by data link layer of OSI reference model? It will work with MAC address. Okay. So it will not care for your IP addressing. But that was the simple example why I connected, because it will not deal with your IP addressing. And when you connect two different IP address, the same IP address subnet to two different PC, it will work with that. But if you want to connect to two different subnets, which will not work, you need to have some kind of a forwarding device. In my case, it's a router. Okay.
Yeah, I think that's the only question.
Yeah. Thank you. All right. So now we are going to discuss how the flow exactly happens. I have connected a PC. Let's say I give the name as PC1, PC2. Okay. This has IP 192.168.1.2. This has IP 192.168.3.2. All right. This is this interface. Let's say that FA0/0. This is having FA0/1. And this interface is having IP 192.168.1.1. And this act as a 192.168.3.1. All right. Now, when my PC wants to talk, and I keep a switch here, and let's say I connect one more PC here, which is having 1.3 IP. When I want to communicate to this PC number 3, and in middle, I have a switch, my PC will send a packet, okay? The packet will say that I want to ping 192.168.1.3 from PC1, okay? It will go with a simple packet form, okay? Ping means it's ICMP protocol. So it's a simple payload of ICMP request, which will be again sending to IP protocol, which works on layer number 3. Now this IP protocol or layer 3, you know that it's get again added here the source IP, the destination IP. Okay, so in my case, source IP is 192.168.1.2. In my case, in other case, destination IP is 192.168.1.3. Okay, and then it will forward this, it will give this packet or hand over this packet to your layer 2, which is in our case, NIC driver. The NIC driver will again give a encapsulation here, and here he will add source MAC, destination MAC. Source MAC, it's known to itself because PC1 knows what is MAC address he has. Let's say that in my case, A.B.C.T. And he is not aware what is the MAC address of PC number 3. Then what he will do that? It will send a broadcast, a ARP request. Okay. It will send an ARP request saying that I am looking for someone whose IP is 192.168.1.3. Can you please reply me back? Okay. This switch will broadcast. It's a MAC, it's a what is called frame broadcast. Let's say that it's all broadcasting on MAC address level. In our case, FFFF. So one request will go to, or one broadcast message will go to PC3. PC3 will see this guy is looking for me, and PC3 will reply back its MAC address to PC1. But that is unicast. And this how PC1 will be having the MAC address of PC3, and he will easily mention it here, EFGH in my example. And then this packet will go here in the frame. It will go in the frame wise to switch. Switch will forward the frame to PC3. PC3 will take out this frame. It will see whom to hand over next on the layer 3. It is IP address in my case. Then the packet will go to layer 3 or IP protocol of layer 3 in PC3. And then it will see, okay, it is the ICMP request, and it will reply back with the ICMP reply. This is the simple scenario. Okay. What if I need to connect or I need to ping from PC1 to PC number 2, which is IP 192.168.3.2? Okay. So first scenario, PC1, what did? It checked whether the destination belonged to same subnet or not. Yes, it's belong to same subnet. It's 192.168.1.2 it has, and it's trying to ping 192.168.1.3. And then the packet, the frame, he will not send to router. It's between these two devices via switch. But if PC1 wants to ping PC3, which IP is 192.168.3.2, it will form this packet, but it will look at its routing table. It will see its routing table, who? The PC1. What is the destination? 192.168.3.2. Am I aware where this destination located? No. Then what should it do? It will transfer blindly that packet to its default gateway, which is in our case, default gateway always your router IP. Okay. It will blindly forward this to default gateway. Guys, trying to understand and put any question if there is any confusion, because once you understand this, you understand routing. Okay. So I explained so far a communication via switch, if locally two PCs are connected, how they will communicate, because they both belong to the same subnet, the traffic will not go to their router because they will see it's in routing table. Now come back to my PC. Here, I want to see my routing table, what exactly it is. So I will type route print. Look at here. I have n number of routings here available. These all are called your 127, it's all called loopback IP, so I'm not bothering about that. What I'm bothering about, the first line, 0.0.0.0, 0.0.0.0 going to my gateway 192.168.1.1. In which case, this routing table or this particular route will be consulted by my PC when my PC wants to communicate to different subnet of IP address, when it's sending any packet to different subnet. So here, sometime back, I was just pinging google.com. And who is replying me back? It's Google. So when I constructed a ICMP packet, okay, I was looking where to send this packet, and it's my in my case, I want to send this packet to google.com. What is the IP of google.com? 172.217.31.46. Is this range same range of mine? No, it's not the same range, because my range is 192.168.1.1. Then what should I do? I should send blindly this packet to my gateway, and my gateway will take care of that. Okay. So this is exactly how your routing starts. Okay. Now let me make some little clean this, and then I'll explain to you how the function goes when it reaches to router. Okay, so let's move to the communication when it happens with router. I have made a router, let's label as R1, connected to a switch, switch connected to my PC1. My PC1 is having IP 192.168.1.2. I am going to connect another PC here, which is having IP, let's say labeled as PC3. I have IP 192.168.3.2. And this interface, which is connected to this PC, should be having IP of the same range as I told you. So it should be 3.1 in my case. And here it should be 192.168.1.1. Now, I want to communicate to PC this 3.2. So there is a ICMP which is responsible for ping. It will first create a ICMP request payload. Okay, this payload will be handed over to IP protocol of layer 3. Layer 3, which protocol works? IP. Okay, so layer 3 IP protocol, this payload will be handed over. This all function happening in PC1, guys. It's internal activity happening. So this payload is handed over to IP. Now IP will look, what is the destination? It's 192.168.3.2. And then your IP will consult with your Windows to find out whether a routing table to find out whether this is in the same range, what IP I have. And it will find out, no, it's a different range. It's 192.168.3.2. It's not 192.168.1. range. It means that it's entirely different subnet. Then it will make, your IP will make silently here, source IP 192.168.1.2, destination IP 192.168.3.2. It's ready. Now it will hand over next to your layer 2. But before handing over to layer 2, your IP will do one more work. Your IP is very intelligent. It will see that it's belong to different subnet. It means that I need to hand over or I need to send this packet to default gateway, the gateway which I have mentioned in my PC. In my case, I shown you it's 192.168.1.1. How do I know what is my gateway? You can just put IP config and you will see what is your default gateway. You can see here. Okay. So in my case, what is my default gateway? 192.168.1.1. Now, that's fine. I need to hand over this packet. This packet I need to hand over to a router, the default gateway, which is in my case router. But I don't know what is the router MAC address, because this complete communications will go with the MAC address. Okay. How will I know? And here your router, your PC will again generate a ARP request. And the ARP request will go via switch to the router. And router will see this PC is looking for the MAC address of 192.168.1.1. And in the response, your router will reply its MAC address. All right. And then your IP will hand over this details. What details? Your gateway MAC address to layer 2. And layer 2, now you will start source MAC, in my case a.b.c.d. And what should be the destination MAC? Destination MAC should not be 192.168.3.2, because I don't know where this guy is located in the internet. What I know is only I have to send this packet to my router. So I should get this destination MAC is my router MAC address. And how did I get this? Through ARP request. Okay. So let's say that router MAC address is a dot b, sorry, a dot e dot f dot g. Okay, now my frame is constructed. It's going via switch, reaching to router. Router will take out this complete outer waste and it will look at the IP address. And what is the destination IP address? 192.168.3.2. So your router will come to know that this packet I need to send to 192.168.3.2. One more very interesting things with router. Router will never bother what is your source IP. Your router will always look where I need to send this packet. So where I need to send in this case, 192.168.3.2, which is this guy. Now router will look at its connected interfaces IP addresses. FA0/0 have IP 192.168.1.1. FA0/1 has IP 192.168.3.1. And this range belong to the destination, which I'm looking for, 192.168.3.2. And it will easily come to know that this particular host, this particular destination is located on this interface, which is FA0/1. And it will switch the packet to here, where FA0/1. Now FA0/1 has received this frame and or receive this packet, and now it will again construct a frame on this where he will mention the source MAC of its interface, and destination MAC should be of PC3. Okay, and then the packet will send back to PC3. So this is how flow goes. Question, if this interface FA0/1 not aware the MAC address of PC03, what it will do? Simple, it will again send a ARP request. The ARP request will go to this PC, PC will reply back its MAC address, then it will note down a ARP table here. And in this ARP table, he will come to know what is the MAC address of PC3. And then it will add that PC3 MAC address into their destination MAC, send the frame to this PC. This PC will remove all the outer lines and it will go directly to the payload. It will see that it's ICMP request and then it will start preparing for the reply. So this is how a flow happens, guys. Questions? If anyone, any question has, you can put in the chat.
Yes, Sandeep, we do have a couple of questions in the chat.
Yeah. So Amit, question, PC1 will send first packet with broadcast MAC. Yeah, you're right. If PC1 is not aware what is the MAC address of my default gateway, it will send a ARP request by broadcasting it. But if it is aware what is the MAC address of my default gateway, then it will not send. Okay, in our scenario, we are dealing with layer 2, layer 3, because your router completely known for layer 3 forwarding packets. And that's the reason we are dealing with only layer 2 and layer 3 here. Okay, so can you send, Sarvesh question, can we send packet to destination without routing protocol? Yes, you can do if you have a default routing or a static route. We will come back to that next slides. Okay. All right, so looks like audience intelligent. They understand what we are explaining here. So yeah, let's move to the next. So I will just shortly show this live by capturing the packet, and then it will be clear for you guys. So let me move here. I have in my lab, you just forgot about FA0/0 onward this topology, but only just focus this portion. Let's say. Okay, just focus on this topology where I have PC3 into that and PC1. And this communication, what I just explained to you in my theory. So let's go to see the practical. PC1, I have already opened here and I have assigned IP 192.168.1.2. So the same, I kept the IP which I explained to you. Okay. And it has a gateway 192.168.1.1. Now come back to PC3. Let me open the switch on the PC3. And so IP, I need to assign IP 192.168.3.2. Okay. Subnet mask. And then what should be the gateway? 192.168.3.1. Now it's checking duplicate address if anyone else having the same IP, but in my case, no. So I can see, so IP now. Okay. Now come back to R1. I'm only dealing with R1 at the moment. So R1, if you see, which is my router one, it has a FA0/0 interface, which is connected to PC1, and FA1/1, which is connected to PC3. Let's configure this. Okay. This, yeah. Somewhere I was not able to. Okay, no way. So I just wanted to show you parallelly along with this. Okay, so let's see R1. I'm going to FA0, FA1/0. In my case, you can see already I have configured IP address 192.168.1.1, and which is the default gateway for PC1. Now I am going to FA1/1. How to go? You need to go to global config, mention interface, FA1/1, and then you need to assign IP address. What IP address should I give here? 192.168.3.1 with subnet mask. No cert. If you want to again see what are the IP address I have assigned, so the command is so IP interface brief. This will give you the list of all the IP address assigned to the interfaces. Okay, so you can see here 1/1 it's having 3.1 and 1/0 is having 1.1. All right, now let me start pinging and I will first capture this here. So Wireshark is the tool which will be helping me to see this communication. Okay. I'm getting similar. Okay, that's fine. I need to stop capture, then put it again. And let me go and put it here. Start Wireshark. Yeah, looks fine to me. Okay, so now I'll go and I'm on PC1 at the moment. And what I need to ping 192.168.3.2 in my case, which is PC3. Okay, and I'm getting reply. Okay, let me stop it here at the moment. At the very first, as I told you, what I'll be looking for, my IP will be looking for the MAC address of my default gateway, because I am pinging the different subnet IP, 192.168.3.1. How will I see that? What is my ARP table? So if you put ARP, so ARP, it will give you the MAC address of your default gateway. What is that default gateway? 192.168.1.1. Okay, so it is aware the MAC address of my default gateway. So in that case, it will not go with the ARP request, which I was mentioning you here. It will not go to ARP request because it is aware what is the MAC address of my default gateway. Come back to next. Now I am sending the packet. Okay, and by the time it's the old capture which I have captured already here. If you can see, it was sent a beginning. A ARP request asking who has 192.168.1.1 IP, please tell me the MAC address. Please check it here, guys. Okay, it is sending a ARP request. What is the destination? FF. This is nothing but broadcast MAC address. And what is the source? If you can see here, source 00507966 6800. This is the MAC address of my PC1. All right. So it is sending the ARP request. And what is the ARP request says? Who is having 192.168.1.1? And this is what I was talking to you. Now, this packet, this ARP request has gone to the router, and router now reply back. But reply will be in unicast format, because now router is aware what is the MAC address of the other guy. Okay, so now your router is aware what is the MAC address of PC1. You got me? And this is where you will see this communication. See this one. So your communication is now, it's coming from the router. This is the router MAC address, and where it's going to destination PC1, and it is replying with its MAC address. You can see ARP, address resolution protocol reply. So first I sent request, which was broadcast. The broadcast received by router. Router replying with a unicast message saying that this is my MAC address. Okay. Now my PC1 is having MAC address. And now here it will start sending the request. Okay. What is sending request? My PC1, which IP is 1.2, is 1. It is sending the ICMP request to 3.2. And if you see the source destination here, this is your router MAC address. But if you go to layer three, look at here. What is your source? 192.168.1.2. What is your destination? 192.168.3.2. So it is your layer three packet is intact. It is not getting changed. What is getting changed is the frame. And in the frame, he is putting the destination MAC of your default gateway of your router. And this is how your packet will reach from PC1 to this FA0/1. Hope you understand what I have explained, what I have shown you with the capture. It's the same. Any question? I think today I should be wind up till here, because this was my main intention to show you what exactly routing flow happens, how it happens, and how the framing happens, how your layer three packet framing happens, layer two happens, and that's where I wanted to show to you. Okay, so now you can ask your questions, and I will wind up the call here, the meeting here, and then I think next we are going to deal with firewall fundamental, which will be announced shortly.
Thank you so much, Sandeep. So guys, thank you so much for patiently listening out and learning a couple of things here. So we are running our own cybersecurity program, which runs for 16 weeks with 12 weeks of core classes and 4 weeks of soft skills and others. We are very flexible towards the classes. It's just 3 classes per week, when one on Saturday and 2 on Sunday. like Mr. Sandeep Rai, there are 10 other experts who are also a part of our course. They are not teachers, they are industry experts, just like Sandeep sir, because the knowledge that they share is going to be very vital. There are all live classes like these classes. Every class is a live class. It's not a recorded class. And some of the topics that you'll be learning over a span would be introduction to cybersecurity, network security, application security, incident management, forensics, governance, identity and access, and SIEM, QRadar, to name a few, over the span of 12 weeks. There's a quick offer running right now, which I've already shared in the chat. So you can pay an upfront payment of 29,999 only, or the other option is 59,999. If you pay 29,999, you get a flexibility to pay the rest of it once you get placed, because we offer placement assistance as well. On the other hand, if you pay upfront, and if you don't get placed, after certain terms and conditions, we'd be more than happy to refund the money as per whatever terms and conditions apply. So I'd quickly urge you guys to kind of check this link that I'm sharing right now. So we are running a quick discount with Sandeep's promotion code. So head out to quickly register for this course and get the maximum benefit out of it. On the other hand, thank you so much, Sandeep, for today's session. I'm pretty sure it was a good session. Went on to the very basic fundamentals of networking. And guys, whatever you go in networking world, in the IT world or cybersecurity, wherever you go, you need to understand network is going to follow wherever you go. So having that knowledge is always going to be important for you as an individual. And as Sandeep sir said, that this is like a series. So we are going to have more of these classes. We will be deep diving into every component one after the other. So stay tuned. And there's a quick survey on your screen. So it's hardly going to take you about a minute. So feel free to start filling up the survey. And guys who have questions, we still have 3 minutes. You can put it up in the chat window. Anybody has any questions? Sarvesh, to answer your question, yes, firewall is included, but it's only in the network security or cybersecurity aspect of it. But then as, no, Palo Alto will not be there, but as Sandeep sir will also be running firewalls, I think the masterclass will cover that. In the course, you will be learning more on the lines of defense in depth and other cybersecurity concepts. Sonal, when you say which one, can you kind of elaborate your question? Which one will be in firewall? It'll be in masterclass. That'll be by Sandeep sir. So that date will be announced quite soon.
Yeah, it should be ASA or FTD. We can touch both.
All right, cool. Thank you so much, guys. I think we are almost at the end of the session as there are no questions. Couple of things. Your certificate will be emailed to you. The email address that was used for the registration purposes. The recording will be available, so you can go back and learn certain things. And if there is any questions in the next session, you can always come back and ask Sandeep sir. I'm pretty sure he'll be able to kind of entertain. But other than that, thank you so much, Sandeep sir, for coming on our platform and doing these networking series. And we hope to see more of these sessions in the future.
Yeah, thanks a lot for the wonderful audience. Thanks to you and the complete Android team. Santanu's question, how to configure interface IP address? I think I shown you while configuring a router. You can just recap from the video.
All right. Okay, guys. Thank you so much, guys. We're done. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.
Yeah, thank you. Bye-bye.